sometimes I just love humanity.
Oh, my name is Karen.
I'm not interested in money, I'm only interested in sex.
Yeah, absolutely.
But I might turn on by really wealthy men.
Hi. Equal numbers of
He's incredibly bisexual.
Perhaps.
And then he told me something incredible. Apparently, I've been doing completely the wrong thing for my hair for 15 years. And he's special, so he should know.
You know who I really hate?
Who?
Prince Andrew.
I don't need men that way. I take care of sex by myself.
Yeah, but I bet you fantasize about men when you
fantasize about right
now. Oh, certainly you ain't all retentive.
I'm pretty busy. I've made the commitments to about 15 girls.
Yes, you may have pulled it up.
He's nice, but he's hard to work.
So many different types together, it feels like
hello, guy.
Hi. Oh, hello, Pope.
Sorry.
Hi, guy, how are you?
Am I on the sex?
Oh, little delivery, yeah.
I think it's incredible. That two people can somehow communicate without words, don't you?
Why do people go to parties?
To meet a partner.
Why do they want to do that?
To go to parties with.
Oh, God.
Any luck?
Yeah. Must be joking.
It's a pity. I'm sure you'd meet someone here.
Too tired. Where are you going?
To the toilet.
I'm coming too. And I don't necessarily want to meet anyone.
It's not
place. This place is crawling with girls. I don't want just any girl. I want the right girl.
Madonna is here.
No, you can't understand. You haven't met her yet.
You haven't met Madonna yet.
No, when I meet this girl, I think I'll know the minute I see her.
But will she know you?
Don't disturb him, darling. He's out with the buses. Don't run.
Madonna who? He's very interested.
What's she like?
Not thin. Absolutely not too thin.
To call her too thin would be utterly false. She's fat.
No, definitely not fat. To call her fat would be a total exaggeration.
No, no, no,
and
mate,
she's completely odorless.
And there's no way to call her bald.
All right, okay. Michelle Bernard.
Oh, beautiful. Yeah. Bernard, doesn't she live in Melbourne?
She's based in Melbourne, mate. Based in Melbourne.
I love this place because it's incredibly cheap. I've got a voucher. I think I've met you before at Steve's. Can't remember it very well.
Yes, I think I remember.
His sister Bronwyn was there. Do you remember her?
I'm not sure.
She's a microwave cookery demonstrator. Does that ring a bell?
Not really.
She's about 5'6", dark hair.
I don't think I remember her.
She married that seismologist. They have a son, Jaden Douglas. He's about 3½. They live in Blackheath. Anyway, if you meet her, could you do me a big favour?
Yeah.
Could you say hi for me? Could you say Michelle says to say hi?
Okay.
She said she thought what you really wanted was a blonde. She said men in Sydney prefer fast blondes. What exactly do you want, guy?
I just want someone a little bit groovier.
OK. okay.
So where do you live?
Excuse me, it takes me a while to remember. I can't stay anywhere long. I'm a comitophobe. It's in the inner city somewhere. It's fabulous.
Excuse me, but there are some guys over there who've been studying us very closely all evening.
Tell them to stop.
No. They're really good friends of mine. They've known me for thousands of years. Guys, come over.
I love you.
I love you more.
Hi. Oh, this is Wazzy, Bill and Quentin.
Hi.
What's up?
Wazzy.
He's fantastic.
Look, I've been sitting over there feeling so sorry for you two.
Yeah.
Dating such a nightmare, isn't it?
What's wrong with you, Mr. Negativity?
Nolly dumped him.
For someone who's a far less interesting conversationalist than he is.
In other words, he's better looking.
Yes. He probably just didn't like you anymore. Where will we all go now?
Oh, look, there's a sudden burst of energy.
Betty, I think there's something wrong with this cat.
Yeah, she's pregnant.
You know who owns her?
No idea.
Hi, Sydney. Do you know whose cat this is?
No, no.
Is this your cat?
No, you have a smoke?
No. Excuse me. Do you know who's...
Oh, my God! She's having kittens! Come in.
Good God. Yes. I suppose I should have taken it to a vet.
Hmm? Oh.
A vet.
I'm a doctor. I'll see what we can do.
Are you really?
Mm-hmm.
Should I, boil something?
Boil what?
Water.
Do you want a cup of tea?
No. This is your cat, isn't it?
No, I thought it was yours.
No! I'm sorry, I was looking for the owner.
Oh.
Look, I don't even know your name.
I'm Lizzie.
Guy.
Oh, look.
She's a wonderful girl.
How did he meet her?
She's a doctor.
He knocked on a door with a pregnant cat about a month ago.
I've thought of that.
Yeah? You have to impregnate the bloody cat, though.
Yeah.
They're getting married.
Oh. Didn't he live with that other girl?
For years.
What was she called? She was a research assistant.
Jenny Follett. After they broke up, he was alone for a while. He was driving us mental.
I'm so happy for him. Well, what happened to the kids?
Put to sleep.
It's for the best.
Did you come out of the sea?
Not exactly. I went to primary school. Then I went to high school.
My father said the choice was mine. I could either be a doctor, or a lawyer, or a piece of shit.
Really?
Not exactly. He's a heart surgeon, so I became a doctor.
You think he's gonna mind that I'm not a...
A doctor? No. No, I'd be fine.
Your hair is such a beautiful colour.
Ah! Well, it's not really blonde, you sweet thing. There's hardly any adult blondes.
It's more like a sort of a mouth.
Don't tell me now. Put the rest of our lives to find out about each other.
Like a mousy sort of...
It'll be boring if you tell me now.
My great-great-grandfather was transported for...
And then I lost my virginity in the 8th of fuck!
Mum said we could have whatever we want.
All I want is a simple affair with our parents and a few close friends, right?
Hello?
Hello, darling. Hi.
How lovely to see you.
Mrs. O'Hara.
Poppy.
Poppy.
This wedding is a total nightmare. I just want to go away and come back when the whole thing is over.
Oh, well, if you feel that way about it, I'm sure we can arrange
to... What do you think of this?
We've only just begun to live.
No, it's a bit sentimental.
Well, if a wedding isn't the time for sentiment, I don't know what is. Guy? Guests. How many?
Oh, my parents, I suppose, and... a few close friends, about 10.
That leaves us with a bit of room. Guy, 10. Lizzie, 87.
Oh, we don't need some of these. We certainly don't need Darren Forbes. He's such a snake.
Anyway, we don't have to invite him.
Good.
He's the MC. He's done it before.
What's this Koori guest?
Oh, darling, I really think we should have one, don't you?
But we don't know any Kooris.
What about a Sri Lankan person? Would that bother you? Someone from the Sri Lankan embassy? Wait a minute. Raoul Hedger. He's very influential at the Belgian embassy.
And darling, what about that little boy? What's his name? Fong...
Fong who?
Guy sponsors him.
He's Vietnamese.
Oh, he's lovely.
Yes, he's a little bit older than that now.
Could we fly him out?
Oh, I don't think so.
Oh. There's Father Montgomery. Mm. He wants to have a little chat with Guy. It's just a formality.
Hello, Father. It's all okay.
Darling. Did she say Father?
Mm-hmm.
So you're,
Yes.
Do you go to,
Oh, no. Only at Christmas. But you love Father Montgomery. He's gorgeous. He's got a great sense of humour.
They all do now. Doesn't prove God exists. Don't misunderstand me, Father. I'm more than willing to go through with all of this for Lizzie's sake. You know, I imagine she wants our children to...
But what about you?
Personally, I don't feel much need to sanctify the union spiritually. But I imagine the legalities are necessary, so...
What about your past?
Yes, of course, you want to know if I've been married before. Well, I'm 32 years old. I've had a fairly typical past. And the answer to that question is no.
Good. That means we can go ahead with the ceremony.
Sweetheart!
Dear Fong Hu, I've got some news to report for a change. I never thought I'd say this. But I finally met someone I want to spend the rest of my life with. I can't imagine ever needing anyone else. I think I'm very lucky because she's the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. I don't know what she wants with me. Her name is Lizzie and she's a doctor.
Oh, God, it's beautiful.
We're having a big wedding in the spring. which is not really my scene, but Lizzie wants it. And as far as I'm concerned, what she wants, I want.
Absolutely sweet. What an unbelievably gorgeous book. And you had it professionally wrapped.
No, I... How did you know that?
Oh. Wait a minute. Oh, I think they've made a mistake. I think they think these elephants are kissing. I think they could be fighting.
What do you think?
They're just connecting, I think.
Oh, good, you've got a teapot. I'll throw mine away.
No, I was gonna throw mine away anyway. You keep yours.
No, I like this one.
I'm definitely throwing it away. It's very old.
No, this one's better.
Not that important, just a material thing.
Nothing wrong with material things, darling. They outlast us.
That's the worst thing about them.
Where did you get it, anyway?
Just ended up with it, really.
So you found it?
No.
What, so you stole it?
No. It's just that I didn't buy it.
Well, who bought it?
Jenny Follett bought it.
Who's Jenny Follett?
Oh, it's just,
Sorry?
I used to go out with her.
Well, why have you got her teapot? Did she bring it along on a date? Did you live with her? Oh, that's okay. Well, I've lived with a couple of men. Just makes our marriage all the more special, don't you think?
Yes, I do think.
What did you do that for?
Because I don't want it.
Guy, if you haven't resolved this...
Of course it's resolved. It's resolved. It was years ago. I wouldn't even know where to find her. I love you. You understand?
That is just wasteful. It's a perfectly good teapot. Yes, I feel normal. Well, what happens now?
Oh, you know.
No, I don't know.
Lovely. Look, I like everyone to assemble down in the bar, so let's move on through, eh? Yes. Thank you.
Sorry.
How are you? Poppy, hello.
It's no good, Mum.
What?
I can feel it.
What?
Polyester.
It's only 2%. Feel it.
Darling, you look unbelievably gorgeous.
Yes. I just knew I should.
Hang on.
Oh, Christine, can you
Thanks. They're all good.
Thank you.
Just one.
Darling? Take two of these.
Yeah,
Excuse me.
Can I have a drink, please?
Ah, absolutely. No problem at all.
The waiter.
Can I have a drink now?
No, no problem at all.
Good. It's Darren.
Hey, Poppy. Hello, Darren.
Come and meet the lucky boy.
Yes. Well, Darren Forbes, Lizzie's cousin. Landscape gardener, specialist in human relations.
Guy. Hi. How do you feel, Lizzie?
I feel normal.
Marvellous.
No, absolutely not. Not under any circumstances.
Could I just have... Sorry, a minute, please.
Darling, I just thought of it. Did you do me a good
one?
You made some time.
Thank you.
Mum. Oh, hello,
Sam.
Hello.
Poppy.
Estella.
Barbara.
Barbara and Derry. This is my husband.
Francis.
Oh, I'm sure we're going to be great friends. Lovely. Thank you.
How are you?
Guy, I'd like you to meet our very good friend, Monsieur Raoul Heger, from the Belgian Embassy.
Very pleased to meet you.
It was so good of you to come. You must be so terribly busy.
Please, I wouldn't have missed it for the world. In Europe, weddings are so important. They mean a great deal.
Oh, may we.
And of course, in Europe, they also mean very little.
To see you.
I may be half blind, but I can see a few things. I've got perception. It's a terrible gift. I'll tell you now, the MC's wearing a wig, and two, this marriage is going to be a complete disaster.
Of course, darling. Come on. That's your wonderful.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Guy Jamison.
We've only just begun.
Oh, spare me.
Not bad. Someone over there seems to be under the delusion that she knows you.
Shush. Hi, Guy.
Oh, she's crazy. Pretend you haven't seen her. Once she's with us, all right, though.
Well, that's good. I know him. His name's Guy Jamison.
Oh, yeah?
Why don't you always get salt and vinegar? Come on, I'll introduce you.
What? No, I don't want anyone to introduce me. It's not the 19th century, sir.
Go up and introduce yourself. No, this is supposed to be a pickup.
No, it's not romantic.
It would be better if we met accidentally. Don't be stupid. We all know what we're here for. So now that goes there. No, it doesn't. It stays there. Hey,
Yeah, okay, fine. Oh, stay away from me.
I'd like to get to know you first.
Oh, so you're taking a big risk there?
Why?
Well, you might get to know me and find out you don't like me, and then you'll miss out on a fantastic
break. Shouldn't we find out if we have anything in common?
Okay, have you ever done the washing up?
Yeah.
So have I. It's awful, isn't it?
His name's Fong Hu. He's an orphan. Pretty cute, huh?
Oh, he's so sweet. And you sponsor him?
Yeah. Somebody came around at work and nobody else would do it, so I thought I should. It's good. I like it. We send each other letters sometimes.
Oh, what do you write to him about?
Oh, everything, really. My impressions of the landscape, universe, trees.
Do you have a job?
I'm a financial controller for a bank.
Oh, good.
Trainee.
Last drinks!
Well, I suppose I better be getting home. Good. Good.
Would do most things well, you know, Mum and I.
Mm.
I was quite worried about you, wasn't I, sweetheart?
Maybe some ginseng.
Ginseng? No, I don't find it does anything for me. I mean, Guy might take it, but...
Have we talked about ginseng shots?
Sorry.
So, you have a husband and three children?
No.
No?
Three husbands and a child.
May I ask what you're thinking?
Well, it's sort of hard to describe.
Try me.
All right. I was wondering what my black top would look like with my taupe ski pants. Well, not over it and not really tucked in, but just sort of scratched.
Not scratched.
What she's really saying is make love to me. Mm.
Do you have a girlfriend?
Yes.
How old is she?
She's 22.
So you think you've had sex, do you?
Oh,
carry him across for Great Britain's first try.
He didn't do make any diversions at all. When the first man missed him, it's an open field of growth coming across.
Darling, I haven't spoken to you all day.
No.
You are one lucky bastard.
I know.
We expect you to work late a few mornings, mate. Mm.
Is that Cheryl Aylesworth over there?
Yeah.
Oh, I'd be careful there.
Why?
Well, you've got to be careful at this point in your life. You know, at this ceremonial point. Mm-hmm. Any friends you've got now, they're going to be in it for the long haul.
Till the very end, mate.
Yeah. I didn't think you were that fond of her.
She's okay. Oh.
We noticed Jenny's not here.
We lost contact.
Right. I thought you two stayed friends.
We did for a while, but, you know, just drifted apart.
Oh, yeah, it can happen. Remind me, why did you two split up?
Remind me, why did you two get together?
I've forgotten.
Hello?
Hello.
You're on the phone again. Oh, sorry.
Hi.
Come on. Hi, it's me. Why do you keep ringing me?
I think it's because I'm in love with you.
Jenny? Oh. Jenny? So are you okay for this weekend?
Why are you introducing me to your family?
It's a test.
Last night, Dominic drank 11 schooners, 3 shots of whiskey, and half a bottle of tequila.
My brother Dominic.
And then he ate the worm at the bottom of the bottle. He's very sick. He's tense. He's waiting on some test results.
Got exams, Dominic.
No, he's got a disease.
Nothing serious, just a nuisance.
It's not his fault. He's sexually transmitted.
This is a tune I penned in an idle hour.
Of which there are many.
I haven't been fortunate enough to find gainful employment for some time. It's a tribute to something we all hold dear.
Oh, Harbour Bridge, we love you so. Your girt is gleam, your arcs they're slow. We gladly pay your tolls, although, and if we could, we'd give you more. Harbour Bridge.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Harbour Bridge.
In honour of your first visit here, Guy, we've done something we do only one day each year.
What's that?
Left the front door completely unlocked. If you leave the front door unlocked on one day of the year only, the chances of a hostile force invading your home on that particular night are so small as to be almost negligible. It's a risk worth taking. Just a statistic I devised in an idle hour.
Have some of Ron's cake, Guy. Mm. His own recipe.
Chinese star jasmine, known for its beneficial properties, including fertility powers. Ut nocte tibi peregrimus voluptas ducere.
Bilingual now.
Latin.
I don't accept it. It's a dead language.
Not Dad. Are you sure you still want to go through with this relationship?
It's too late.
I'm in the no choice phase now.
Opera, opera, opera. Sorry about you.
Lovely.
Neil, I'm a friend of Lizzie's.
Melanie, friend of Guy's. Charming wedding.
It's a farce. What are we celebrating?
The end to loneliness?
I'm mourning the beginning of togetherness when the characteristics which attract inevitably start to irritate.
So you're single?
But why else have we been seated together?
How have you managed to escape us?
Well, over the years, I've learned the types of females to avoid. I find that doesn't leave any at all.
And which types are they?
Let me list them for you.
Women who can't.
Absolutely not under any circumstances.
I started a joke which started the whole world crying.
Harvey?
Hi, Boo.
I missed the ferry again. I finished work early, so I thought I'm going to catch the ferry. And then I realised I'm wearing my shoes. I think, better catch the bus. I get halfway to the bus stop, and I think I really want to catch the ferry. Oh, yeah, I rang Cheryl. She said to say hi.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God, it was the most fantastic trip, though. I sat right at the top. It wasn't too windy. And there was the most fantastic kind of orangey, blue, pinky kind of sunset, and the clouds were really low. And oh, I bought a new cactus.
Oh, just what we need.
Don't listen to a little cactus. You know, Tanya, it's still taking too long with the reports.
Do?
What?
You have to tell me everything you've done during the day.
Gobby, I don't keep a diary.
Well, you should keep a diary. Have you got an address book yet?
I've started an address book. What?
Nothing. No,
I got your shorts.
No,
what's wrong with the shorts? I made these shorts.
They're
great shorts. don't be hugging me. I had this fantastic idea today. Now that we're living together, I think that we should have a dinner party.
Why?
Isn't that what couples do?
No. Do this.
You bit my bottle.
Oh, shit.
So?
What?
Who are we going to invite to our dinner party?
Our friends?
And who are they?
Oh, do you have to play that shit?
I like it.
We're not inviting Cheryl.
Cheryl's not a friend, she's a show.
What about your brother Dominic?
Dibby.
I like
him. Cheryl's psychic, you know. You know what she said to me the other day?
Psychic. She's the most unpsychic person I've ever met. She's predicted, as far as I can remember, the sex of five babies. She was wrong in every case. She's so wrong, she defies statistical probability. She's supernaturally wrong.
She predicted we'd get married. And that we'd have a baby named Barney.
I rest my case.
Short for Barnaby.
Barnaby. I loathe the name Barnaby.
That's a pity, I really like it.
I'm having a baby called Barnaby.
That the joke was on me. Oh, the joke was on me.
Thank you very much. I'll be back in 20 minutes.
And finally, I avoid women who perceive their lives as a fundamental tragedy because they are liable to burst into tears at awkward moments such as during lovemaking.
But in spite of these well-researched findings on women, Neil, I guarantee you that if I employ certain foolproof methods, which require very little effort on my part, you will leave here in my thrall.
How would you do that?
I could try the call girl method. Which is to wait until either ego or inebriation gets you into a confessional mode and then stare at you with a peculiar mix of affection and understanding. Or there's the nuisance method, which is to bother you until you have to kiss me to get rid of me. Oh, and if that fails, there's always the technique of non-revelation. For that, I simply do and say as little as possible and allow myself to be a total repository for your fantasies.
If you'll excuse me, I just have to say hello to a friend of mine.
Mate, chicks, huh? Chicks these days, they're voracious.
Yeah.
No. They'll try and get you into bed, but, mate, you just don't let them.
No.
And you've always got the upper hand. Just don't give in.
That way.
Excuse me. Angelo. Do you think you could take your hand off my knee at all?
I don't understand, chicks. My girlfriend complains that I touch her enough. Hey!
Hey, let me have a go.
Did you wash this?
No.
Why not?
I'm committing suicide slowly by not washing the pesticide off for it. Hi, mate. When are we going to have sex again?
Oh, I'm not really keen, are you?
No. It's normal.
Yep.
It's inevitable.
So what are we going to do about it?
Well, there's only one thing I can think of offhand.
What?
Well, I've stayed for 6 months, and if during that period you want to have sex with me, I'll charge you $100.
Okay.
75 for seeing me without my clothes on.
Exactly how much is this teapot?
$74.99.
You knew. You're chilling, you know. You really are. You take my breath away.
Still here.
Great.
What do you reckon?
Nice.
Thanks. Yes.
I just wanted to know that I didn't mind giving you that money at all, okay? I don't want you to think that I begrudged it or anything like that.
Fair enough.
I think it was money really well spent. I didn't feel ripped off in any way. Oh, God, I love you.
What's wrong?
I want to spend $100.
What?
I want to spend $100. Now.
Now?
Now. I'll give you the rest later. Do you mind not reading over my shoulder, please?
Why not?
Because I can't stand
it. Why? Why?
Because I couldn't concentrate on the story I was reading. I needed a little bit more privacy.
Here's a story for you.
What?
Melinda went out with this guy, right? And one day she decided she wasn't going to take any trouble at all. No makeup, nothing. Just be relaxed. And when she opened the door to him, he said, "Gee, Melinda, you look horrible."
And?
And what?
And what happened then?
I don't know.
That's it?
Yeah.
That's the whole story?
Yeah.
That's the most pathetic story I've ever heard in my life.
It's very lifelike.
Well, I need more in my stories than that, which is why I read and you don't. God, I hate Christmas. This is the last year we're going to my parents. Next year they can come here. And we're not cooking anything. They can just come to the door and drop off their presents.
Can't do that.
Why not?
God, could you come here? Could you hold my legs for me?
Santa cutie, and fill my stocking with a duplex and check. Sign your X on the line, Santa cutie, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Come and trim my Christmas tree with some decorations bought at Tiffany.
Make yourself useful. Give me some tinsel.
I really do believe in you. Let's see if you believe in me. Santa, okay. Baby, forgot to mention one little thing. A ring. I don't mean on the
phone. Are you flirting with me?
Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Hurry down the chimney tonight. Hurry. Tonight.
I thought we didn't do this anymore.
Obviously, I'm not to be trusted.
I hope guys told you about his wild youth.
Oh, don't.
I'd love to hear about it.
No, this will be total shit.
I want to hear this.
Oh, yes. Traffic regulations breached, library books not returned on time. And once he played indoor cricket in a hall that was a real fire trap. Has Guy told you about his hair-raising adventures overseas?
No.
It was in the wilds of the English countryside.
Please, I've heard it too often.
Yeah, but unless you count the time he was invited to two parties on the same night, it's the one big thing that's ever happened to him.
True. Well, tell me about it.
Oh, no, I really don't want to talk about it.
Oh, go on.
Go on.
Go on.
Well, I was,
Guy?
Absolutely delicious.
Did you tip her?
Yes.
You wouldn't even let me have a cupcake with my cup of tea.
I don't think you realise how class-ridden this country is.
As soon as you open your mouth here, you slot it in. They can tell by your accent that lady probably has a very difficult life.
Yeah, but Guy, we needed that money.
Not as much as she does.
Was this in a stupid book of yours?
Oh, now, this is a fascinating book. I've had a lot of insights into this place from reading this book. You would be well advised to have... Look at those trees.
I'm not waiting. You hear what I said? I'm not waiting. You can catch up.
Like that, Guy?
Who do you think you are?
Excuse me. I'm so terribly sorry to trouble you, but I wonder if you'd happen to know about the bus timetables around here. Oh, I'm sorry, we're not locals, we're Australians. Of course you are. How stupid of me. What an absolutely stupid question to ask of two Australians.
But you couldn't have possibly known that we're Australians.
No, I should have known straight away. My deepest apologies. There's a rugged, untamed quality about your faces. Excuse me, I'm being awfully rude. Rupert Harwood.
Guy Jamieson. This is Jenny Follett. Hi.
So, do you live around here, Rupert?
I don't live anywhere, really. A bit of a drifter.
Oh.
Guy says everybody's slotted in here. It's because of the class system, which is terrible.
Really? Mm. Oh, I don't really know very much.
So, where do you live, Rupert?
Look, here's my address. Please, feel free to call on me there at any time.
Here's ours. And if you ever come to Australia, you must come and stay with us.
Oh, look, I wouldn't want to.
No, I insist.
I went to Australia once. Loved it to death. Why don't I look over there for a picnic spot?
Oh, sure. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. Here. No, don't lose that piece of paper.
Loved it to death.
Well, what's the thing about the English second? Say something like that and get away with it.
The old rectory, Chestnut Farm, Pinkney's Cream, Warpswilton, Buckinghamshire. I'm the Queen Bloody Mother.
You are so cynical, you know. He's a very interesting fellow. I can't understand why you don't like
him. Oh, he thinks he's fantastic.
He said he knew he was good looking, but that was just to illustrate a philosophical point.
I don't believe that either.
What?
That he was good looking. You just...
I wonder if you two would care to join me in a glass of port from a bottle which has been in my family for generations and now just happens to be in my knapsack.
Fantastic.
Just a quick one.
Wow. Oh, whoa.
Cheers.
Cheers. Thank you.
Guy? Guy?
Unconscious, but I somehow managed to find my way to hospital, and then suddenly I was in London and everything was okay.
Chucky!
Hey! Hi! Guy?
You probably know me as Worm.
Worm got me where I am today.
I smuggled some cardiology notes into our final exam.
In his Ugg boots.
It's cheating.
Yeah. Yeah. That is great.
Excuse me. Cognac, champagne?
Yes, thank you.
Two champagne.
What did you mean before when you said that in Europe, weddings mean very little?
I mean, in Europe, they're not always connected to love. This country is not as civilized.
I love Lizzie.
Of course you do. She's a wonderful girl. I've known her since she was this high.
Have you ever been married before?
Three times.
Three times? That's very civilized.
This is your first marriage, Joe?
Yes.
Yes. I spent a lot of time with a girl in my 20s. I was seen for a long time.
That is lucky.
Why?
To have a woman's young years is a wonderful thing. I had the benefit of my first wife's young years. After our divorce, I did not want to see her. I like to remember her just the way she was when we were together.
I quite enjoyed that. I think we should subscribe next year.
Subscribe? You're going straight from youth to old age and missing the middle bit.
What's the middle bit? You know I'm not ready for that yet.
Only three children?
No.
Two?
No.
One very thin one.
You're a funny thing. Why do you want children all of a sudden?
I don't know. I suppose I'm some sort of weirdo.
Hey.
Lucky guy.
The vest looks nice.
What?
No, no. No,
I'm
saying it looks nice. It's nice. It's all right.
What's wrong?
If you think I'm going to tell you what happened at work today, you've got another thing coming. Guy, did you hear what I said?
Yeah.
Well, what do you think?
Good, good.
Because of what you said to Cheryl last Friday. She said I poured everything out onto you. She said it sounded like you were going off me.
I didn't say that you poured everything out on me. I said that you poured everything out to me.
It wasn't a criticism. It wasn't a complaint. It was a statement of fact.
If you had said to me, which implies a generous act of giving, it might have been, but you said on me, which implies an aggressive act of suffocation.
Wait, since when is Cheryl the... Oh, this is it?
Mm-hmm.
This is the table set. You happy with this?
Very happy.
It's pathetic.
I don't think so.
Where's the salt? Where's the pepper? Where are the serviettes? Where's anything that they might need during the meal? Will you fix this up, please? They're gonna be here in 15 minutes.
Hello.
How are you?
Guy's locked himself in the kitchen cooking. So annoying.
How are the renovations going?
Good.
Oh,
quite a collection of cat dust.
Yes, it's growing. It's very exciting.
Isn't it wonderful? Oh, and look at all the stencils.
Hi.
Good evening. I hope you enjoy tonight's meal. I've tried to make sure you won't go short of anything you need. For instance, if the lights go out, which could happen, there's this or this. If Guy annoys me during the meal and I have to throw water all over him and it goes all over you, Mrs. Jamison, you've got this. Or, what's this? And if you can't stand Guy's cooking but you don't want to say so to avoid hurting his feelings, you could sneak one of these, which you could heat up with this. And if boredom sets in, God forbid, there's always this. Or this. Or this.
Why are you doing this?
Because I hate you.
Yeah. I hate you too. Just as long as you haven't gone off me. You complete. Oh, God.
She's collecting a man and sees this lunatic galloping down the road with a pregnant cat.
And for me, that was it, really.
That was what? That was fate.
Well, you know, you know at one look that she's the one that you want to be with forever. Has that ever happened to you?
Yes, darling. Hundreds of times.
It was a magical moment. It felt preordained.
Yes, Lizzie's been planning it for years. She's been saying since she was 10 years old she'd be married at 30.
Oh, darling, you don't look a day over 25.
How long after that did you decide to get married?
6 weeks.
Oh, what?
Well, you couldn't expect me to make a commitment like that to someone I knew.
Yes. Where have you been?
Out. Are you folding my clothes for me, Guy? You don't have to do that.
Jennifer, are these clothes clean or dirty?
What?
This pile of clothes has been lying on the bedroom floor for 3 weeks. I've now transferred them into the lounge room because I can't bear to sleep with them anymore. What I want to know is exactly what is the status. They're not clean or dirty, are they? They're resting. I've seen what you do over the years. You rest your clothes.
Wear them once, then you stick them in a pile. Then when they're fully revived, you put them on again.
Do you think I'm dirty?
I think you're worse than dirty. I think you're mad.
That's funny, because I found out that you're mad as well. Doesn't matter, though.
I need more room. I'm sick of it. I'm sick of living in a flat full of cactuses.
Cacti! There's 108 varieties. Cacti. And other succulents.
Boo, what are you doing?
I'm looking for Fong Hu's
book. What?
Oh, I just want to drop him a line.
What's he got to do with this?
Hi, Fong, how are you going? You know, that incredibly kind friend of yours has been real shit to me lately.
Be careful with that, please. I'm going to have that framed.
That's okay, Boo! Because every time he's a shit to me, he sends you money. Oh, so that's what Fong Hu looks like now. You know, in all the years we've been together, have you ever told him about me?
I don't... No. No.
Why not? Why not?
No, because he's just an innocent boy. He's an orphan. There are cultural differences. He would want to know why we were living together without being married. He wouldn't understand.
Understand what?
Oh, Boo, I need more space in my life.
Space is empty, Guy. You can't see it. You can't touch it.
There's lots of important things that you can't touch. I feel...
I don't want to talk about your feelings.
No. No. Neither do I. That's the point. I don't seem to have any anymore. The magic's gone, hasn't it? We can't get it back.
Why would we want to do that?
Because we're alive!
So, what do we do now?
I don't know.
Is this the end of the line? Absolutely gorgeous.
Oh.
It's a wonderful venue. It's big.
How's Jenny?
She's fine. Yeah.
Oh.
Guy, Mum's got a surprise. It's fine. Here's a letter from your little Vietnamese friend. It just arrived.
Really? Yeah, she's a...
Big darling, the speeches are starting.
Ladies and gentlemen, my daughter, Elizabeth, and... I have to get used to it. My son-in-law, Guy, are pleased that you could come together today to help them celebrate the happiest day of their lives.
We can only live forever, you know. They've already invented ways, but they don't want to tell us, so we don't hang them out. Well, I can take a hint.
As the father of three lovely girls, two of whom were snaffled up pretty smart...
I don't like that word, snaffled.
I can't say that I'm unused to making speeches at weddings. Though, I must confess, we'd more or less given up on Lizzie. When she came to us with a fellow who'd apparently turned up at her door with some cock and bull story about a cat. This was a whirlwind romance. But there's always a background to whirlwind romances in the lives and hearts of the participants. Ladies and gentlemen, please join with me in a toast to wish Lizzie and Guy every happiness throughout their marriage. To the bride and bridegroom, Elizabeth and Guy.
Elizabeth and Guy.
Don't fucking touch me!
Thank you, Francis. Can I just say how delighted I am to be welcomed into your family with such open arms and to be marrying your beautiful daughter. And it's true, I knew from the first moment I saw her that I had met the perfect girl. When Lizzie and I became engaged, one of the first people I told was a little boy, he's a teenager now, a Vietnamese boy, who I've been sponsoring for a few years. Just today, I received a reply from him. I had a speech written out, but I'm actually going to read out his reply instead because I think it says everything that I wanted to say, only better. Dear Mr. Guy, thank you for your much-wanted letter. I am glad you are getting married. I like you very much, and I want you to be happy as you have made me. I'm glad that at length you have met someone you love. Love is something of the best and greatest that humans can have. It is exceptional to love and to have someone who loves you. That is what we all search for at length in my town. If you have this, you have everything. You are my best friend in the world, and I wish you all the happiness. My parents also send their best wishes and hope that your marriage will be as long and as happy as theirs has been. Congratulations, Mr. Guy.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Jamison will now dance the bridal waltz.
Hong Hu's parents are dead. Who wrote that letter?
Look, I know you wrote to him, but his letter didn't arrive, so Mum had to write it herself.
What?
Guy, she worked really hard on it.
Thank you.
darling. There's absolutely nothing here for me. What about him? No, I've already had one of those.
Close the garage door?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Hi, Dad.
Hi.
How are you?
Away, Peter.
Hi, to Ophelia.
Oh, guys.
Hi.
Hi. Put some shoes on, darling.
Yes, darling. Put some shoes on.
I've just had a pot of tea. Would you like a cup?
Love one. Here, I'll get it.
Here's an eye opener for you. The Queen's residence is surrounded by 20 hectares of beautiful gardens containing some of the world's rarest and most unusual plants and shrubs. It's a disgrace. There are 690 rooms with more than 10,000 windows.
You wouldn't need all those. He's joined the Republican Association.
Annual costs include £82,000 for laundry, and there are over 300 clocks. Now, who winds all those? Somebody else.
Mum, could you come in here?
Jenny,
Guy and I have a bit of an announcement to make.
We've decided to split up.
The long relationship you have in your 20s probably won't be the final one.
Every relationship has a natural end.
And we feel that we've reached ours.
Yeah.
We're both fine.
We still love each other.
Basically, it's time to explore new horizons. Mm. There'll be a grieving process.
How long will that be?
Oh, about a year. 2 months.
The Queen's annual telephone bill can be as much as £160,000. Other costs include £6,000 for newspapers, £60,000 for wine, and close to £200,000 for groceries.
About time to cut the cake.
Oh, really? Yeah.
With your husband.
Oh, I'll just see if I can find him somewhere. You haven't seen him. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, it's lovely.
Oh. I've never seen Guy anywhere but a cut the cake.
Tall guy, blonde hair. Oh.
Oh,
cake.
Is it real? Can we eat it?
Oh, I see. Guy. It would have been great if that letter had been true. It would have been perfect, but it just didn't arrive on time. No, we had to compromise. It's life. Hey, you have to admit it was clever. Well, I'm gonna cut the cake.
The new friends today?
Yes, we did indeed.
Did you like them?
No, did you?
No.
And did they speak to anybody?
Oh, no, sweetheart. They spoke to everybody. They had a fantastic
night. I think I've ruined this.
Oh, nice. Oh, oh God. Oh, God. Oh.
Don't bother, darling. You never get it off.
Really?
No.
Okay.
Darling. One thing I don't want. Perfect marriage. I mean, oh, that would be so boring, wouldn't it? Because
people aren't perfect, are they? And, you know, I think this relationship has a better chance of survival if we acknowledge that we're not perfect.
Yes, you're probably right.
Good. I think we're going to have a wonderful marriage, Guy. Because, look, we're both independent people. And we love each other. You know, a lot. And, you know, we know that what we do, I mean, you know, like other people, it's not going to affect the marriage at all, is it? Darling? You know, Julie and Clyde? Had other partners, and, well, you know, it should have worked out marvelously, but the problem was they didn't trust each other enough. And, I mean, we're both adults, right? We're fully grown, and I think that we should give each other a certain amount of freedom, because I love you. I mean, that's a given. And I think we're going to have a wonderful marriage, Guy. I know we are.
Did you want your spade?
In here?
Yeah. Come on. Come on, we'll never get there by lunch.
Okay.
Come on, Palski.
But I've got to get my lollies.
Oh, no, we got some here. Come on.
We've got my lollies.
Yeah, I got your lollies.
Dear Fong Hu, I'm sorry I haven't written for a while, but I've been very busy at work. Yeah. And small children don't leave much time for anything else.
Oh, good, sweetheart. You brought your trumpet.
Darling,
did you forget something?
Come
on, darling. Oh, the lollies.
Quickly.
You really shouldn't have any lollies.
It's okay. I thought
I had
them with me.
Come on,
Dom. I was so pleased to hear about you graduating from agricultural college.
Yes.
And with such a good pass.
Come on, let's go.
You're a slow coach.
Let's go. Quick.
Hey, in the car.
Quick, in the car.
I wish you all the very best of luck for the future.
What's Mommy doing now?
Me and Lizzie and the children are all very well. And so is work. Thanks for asking.
Do you want Rocket Barbie? Is Rocket Barbie there?
You also ask me if I'm happy. But that's a hard question to answer. The trouble with happiness is you don't know when you have it. You remember it. Ask me in another 10 years. Maybe I'll be able to tell you.